Tonight, I'm here to recognize my brother, JD. Many of you know him as a friend, many of you know him as an artist, many of you know him for his ability to recognize talent before anyone else does. If he's not recognizing and developing talent through the rap game, which is in their fifth season now, he's continuing to not only build upon that idea of making great music and making great contributions to our music, to our culture. I mean, if selling 400 million albums isn't enough, Jermaine Dupri continues to persevere. He continues to build a legacy by way of establishing a record company in 1993. So Def created an amazing roster. If it wasn't Bow Wow, if it wasn't The Brat, if it wasn't Escape, if it wasn't Jagged Edge, and a multitude of other collaborations as well, he was continuing to build upon that legacy with people like myself, Mariah Carey, Jay-Z, Alicia Keys, TLC, and the list just keeps going on. And I mean, I could just continue to talk about all the things that he's done. But what I recognize is that the man is able to be a channel. Be a channel to be able to recognize a person's story and then help articulate it. Something that everybody can benefit from, whether it's love that you're talking about, whether it's a good time that you're talking about and enjoying in the club. He's been able to be a part of curating that soundtrack of the life that we live and the experience that we have in America. So I recognize him for that. I also, too, recognize him for being a breaker of barriers. To this day, there still is not an R&B album that has sold enough to be certified for a diamond album. And that album is Confessions. That's just to talk about the genius and the barrier breaker that he is. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Don Chi Chi, JD, Jermaine Dupri.
I definitely feel like at some point it was put to be like, this is what you're supposed to do. It's like, regardless of what you want to do, this is your destiny. You're supposed to do this. I kind of always knew that I was going to do music some kind of way, but I didn't like the way that I was being brought into the music. Hip-hop kind of broke the mold of how I was learning, because I was learning from a traditional way. I was going to vocal lessons and I was taking piano lessons, and hip-hop kind of gave me a different avenue to learn a different way. Actually, I got an opportunity to see the greatest DJs that pioneered DJing at my younger age, and that was just something that I was blown away with. These artists that I was friends with when I was a kid were the biggest artists in Atlanta, and then that energy, I feel, was put in me to become one of the biggest artists in Atlanta.
Welcome to Atlanta, where the players play, and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
The DJing part of my life, I feel, was like school for me, because it was the teaching and introduction to all type of music. DJing is like playing a guitar, man. You know what I mean? It's an instrument. DJs all play the same instrument, but they play different. A real true DJ is not scared to take a chance on something that he likes. And if you play it and the people like you, then you've broken ground right there, right? That's a barrier that you've broken.
Yeah, I want to floss with us. Across the board, we burn it up. Drop a little paper, baby, toss it up. Yeah. Slacking on your pimping, turn it up. See the money, y'all.
DJs have made it cool for all races to listen to all music. You go to Vegas, everybody's in the club is basically the same. They look different, but they basically have the same heartbeat and their whole mindset is the same. They're there to party as long as the DJ provides the music. Just to say that I'm 2018 Breaking Barriers recipient is huge to me. To be accepted and be honored at an award show amongst people that I always wanted to be around and amongst people that I continue to want to be around is a big achievement to me.
Yeah. Like Kobe and Shaq, so take that. Long Beach is on the motherfucking map. The city by the sea, R.I.P.J.D. You know about the LBC. My niggas love the Steelers, cold-hearted killers. Real capillas, real fillers. Ain't no squillers, a lot of dope dealers. Bang, diggy dang dang. Dog pound, gangster, crip gang. Yeah, we do the damn thing. Go to Pomona, scoop up. Head to the church house to get a little workout. Smoke out, drink up. Now put your bank up. It's all on me. I got a scenery to stank up. Crank up the beat. Raise up the heat. I'm throwing a block party on 2-1 streets for show.
Hey, y'all, I'm from New York.
New York.
You said I'm from New York. New York. Heads be up in New York. Be bustin'.
Welcome to New York, motherfucker. Where we don't play and out of towners get got like every day. And a gangster's a gangster in every way. Sitting on 22s, that's what long money do. Now the dawn's on it, Diddy shine on it. Tell Flex to run it back and drop a bomb on it. Sunday we layin' low in Halo, sipping Chris and we straight. Monday we go to Bungalow 8. Tuesday I'm in spa drunk doing the shake. And for the rest of the week we just follow the freaks. You can spot us out of town by the way that we walk, the way that we talk. Cocky the state of New York. Hype now, top down.
Game.
New coupe, no roof, player, what's my name? Now Brooklyn, Queens, Manhattan, Staten, Uptown, what now? Let's make it happen.
Friday, shark walk, high with the Franks. Yeah. Right on the floor is where you can find me.
homies. On Saturday, it's up to he's and for she's. You can find me up in one tweezin'. Sunday, that's when I get my sleep in. Cause on Monday, we be at it again. Holla.
Hands up. Hands up.
Put your hands up.
Hands up. Hands up. Hands up. Hands up.
Give it up for my brother,
JD,
the legendary Jermaine Dupri.
Hey,
hey,
JD,
Bow Wiggles,
Bow yeah. Wizard.
Listen, first of all, I want to thank God, because I started in this business when I was 12 years old. So to be here to this day and still doing this, But when I started when I was 12, they told me that I was too young to be a producer. I broke that barrier. After that, they told me that I was too country to be in the music business because I was from Atlanta. I broke that barrier. And that's why this award really means so much to me, because this really touches my soul. Because I had to go through a lot of things to get to this place. You know what I mean? A lot of people stood in front of me. A lot of people told me no. A lot of things that I had to do, I had to go around it. I had to break through it. So breaking barriers is what I'm always trying to do, and I'm going to keep trying to do that as long as I live. First of all, I want to say thank you to all of these guys on the stage, because they are my friends. There's a lot of people that don't have friends in this industry. These guys really are my friends. I've been going to Puff parties since I was a teenager. Me and him been rocking for a long time.
Oh, yo, you older than me, JD.
What? No, you older than me. All right, look. Hold up.
We love
say,
you, JD.
I got to say, Usher. Listen, Usher came to me, and he was in a very, very crazy spot in his life as far as with him and the label and what they was going to do with his career. And he and I sat down, and we talked about his project, and he said he wanted to do it my way. And I said, well, we're going to do it your way. We're going to do it your way, and we're going to break that barrier. And we broke that motherfucking barrier. You know what I'm saying? We did what we had to do. So then, you know, my man Snoop. I got a story for everybody up here. Me and Snoop, we've been down since 1992. Snoop used to sleep in crisscross hotel rooms and kick it with the crisscross guys, right? And we used to hang out all the time. I've been supportive of this dude. Listen, I've been supporting Snoop, and he's been supporting me since day one, right? Snoop called me one day and said, yo, I got this little artist named Bow Wow. You need to put your hands on him, do what you gotta do. He gave me Bow Wow. Bow Wow came to me when he was 12 years old. He sold 3 million records. Ludacris. Chris used to come to my house, my mother's house, and put his CD over the gate and begged me to sign him because he had an afro, and he said he looked like my son, my record label. And he was like, yo, I need to be part of that. And the first thing I did with Chris was I put him on Madden 2000, what was it, 2000?
2000.
Yeah.
Yep.
I put Chris on this Madden game before he was an artist, before I knew anything about what we was gonna do with him, anything like that. And this been my family since day one.
Yes, yeah.
And I just wanna say I'm happy that I could share this with these guys on the stage and all of the DJs. You know, like I said, I started DJing first before I started producing. I feel like this is one of the most important award shows that ever existed to hip hop. So I wanna thank Sean Prez, the Global Spin Awards, Puff Daddy, and Revolt. Y'all don't really understand how important this award show is, because, like he said, like Snoop said, a lot of times these guys, we don't get that recognition that we supposed to. But whenever I have a record,
Anybody else got a record? The first person we run to is who?
DJ.
I said the first person we run to is who?
DJ.
Thank you. Good night.